JP will do it wrong, so we're here to do it right. Welcome back to the Gridiron Expert, bringing you another edition of our GE Top 25, this time heading into week 7 of the college football season, the official start of the second half of the college football season. And after a wild week 6 that saw 7 top 25 teams go down, there are a lot of shakeups in our rankings, including 5 teams that dropped out, bringing in 5 newcomers, and a handful of changes in our top 10 as well. So let's not delay it any further. Before we get to our rankings, though, please continue to like, comment, subscribe, share our videos, and of course, check out everything down in the description below, including our expert picks over on our website, thegridironexpert.com. You do not want to miss out on those spread picks, guys. We're on a 36-15 run over the last 5 weeks. So if you want guaranteed winnings, big-time winnings, and the best customer service any handicapper in the country is going to give you, this is the place for you. Go check it out. The link for it down in the description below. Again, some of the best spread picks in the entire country, hitting over 61% of our bets so far this season, over 75% in our best bet section. This is the place for you if you want to win. So let's take a look at our GE Top 25, guys. Again, a lot of changes from our wild weekend of college football, and we know that each edition of this every single Monday, it's only going to get wilder. So take a look at the top 10. This first column over here, the top 3 teams remain unchanged, and that's to be expected. Everybody took care of business. Georgia made a statement. Everybody thought Kentucky might give the Bulldogs a bit of a fight, maybe a bit of a scare in Athens. They won 51-13 and put over 601 yards of offense on the Wildcats. It was a statement victory. Over 600 yards for the Bulldogs, under 200 yards for the Wildcats, held Kentucky just 55 rushing yards. Phenomenal performance, showing why they are the number one team in the country. Michigan showing why they're right behind them, and there's not as large of a gap as people think. The Wolverines might be the most complete team in the entire country. They went on the road and beat Minnesota 52-10, as expected. Michigan comes in at number 2. Florida State in at 3 after beating Virginia Tech 39-17. Now, the Seminoles maybe haven't been blowing people out of the water as badly as fans want them to, but they're still getting the wins. At the end of the day, that's all that matters. They're still a top 4 team in the country. If they keep this up, they will be in the college football playoff. Behind Florida State, we saw a handful of changes because we saw a couple teams lose in the top 10. A handful of changes in the top 10. Penn State, Ohio State, Washington, Oregon, all moving up one spot. Why? Because of the loss of Texas. Texas lost to Oklahoma. So Penn State up one spot after a bye week for them. Ohio State up one spot following the win over Maryland 37-17, a game where Ohio State actually trailed by 7 in the second half before going on a large spurt with a 27-24 run. It was unbelievable for Ohio State. They move up a spot. Washington, Oregon, both up a spot after getting their bye week. Huskies and the Ducks square off this Saturday. So one of these teams is going to lose on Saturday. Stay tuned for that. And then we got Oklahoma and Texas at 8-9. Oklahoma rising 8 spots in our rankings. We did not have the Sooners as high as some people thought they should be. We said, look, they haven't really played anybody. They've looked good, but where's their strength of schedule? Where's the quality of opponent that deserves them to be ranked towards the top 10? Texas was that opportunity for them, and Brent Venables and the Sooners seized that opportunity in a game for the ages. A game that I said was absolutely on crack. A game that I said was one of the best Red River rivalries that we will ever see and have ever seen. The greatest, one of the greatest additions that we're going to see in the Big 12. This is the last meeting between these programs in the Big 12. Oklahoma winning 34-30 over Texas, scoring the game-winning touchdown with just 15 seconds remaining. It was a legacy drive for Dylan Gabriel. It was a massive, massive win for Brent Venables and the Sooners. They skyrocket in our rankings well into the top 10. They are the front runners in the Big 12 as of now. They are a legitimate college football playoff contender. They do own the edge right over Texas, who we have dropping 5 spots. Again, losing to Oklahoma, dropping 5. Some may say that's way too far, but for us, we believe that's about just right. Cannot justify putting Texas over a team like Ohio State, Washington, Oregon, somebody like that after falling to Oklahoma. So Sooners get the edge over Texas. Who gets the edge over Alabama? Because the Longhorns did go on the road and beat Alabama back in week 2. They get the edge over them. The Crimson Tide coming in at number 10. Cracking the top 10, though, after their big win on the road at College Station, beating the Aggies of Texas A&M 26-20. A really, really big win for Nick Saban and his squad, and a very impressive performance from Jalen Milroe, who last year got the start against Texas A&M, didn't look all that great. This year, on the road, throws for 321 yards and 3 touchdowns. A big-time win for the Crimson Tide. They remain the front runners in the SEC West. So that rounds out our top 10. A lot of shakeups there. Oklahoma, the biggest mover, but Texas was in our top 4 last week. They are plunging now to number 9. Over in the second column, North Carolina rising 2 spots, getting up to number 11, right on the outside looking in after their dominant win over Syracuse. Look, I know Syracuse was not ranked. I know Syracuse had just gotten the brakes beaten off of them against Clemson, but this was an impressive victory for UNC. It was a dominant defensive performance. Drake May threw for over 440 yards. This is the North Carolina team we all were hoping and expecting to see, and they showed up in a big way with a massive win over a good Syracuse team. They're not elite. We know they weren't ranked. They're not ACC title contenders, but this is still a solid, complete team, and UNC made them look like nothing, winning 40-7. So they definitely are a fringe top 10 team. They're ahead of a team like USC. Pac-12, lovers, destroy me. Go ahead. You know, come after me. Well, USC has not looked the part. USC barely survived Arizona on Saturday night, Pac-12 after dark, winning 43-41 in not one, not two, but 3 overtimes. They were lucky to escape. And if you look at USC this year, they really haven't played anybody either. They did not look great against Arizona State out in the desert. They did not look all that great against Colorado, allowing the Buffaloes to come back and make that game a lot closer than it needed to be, only winning 48-41. And then against Arizona, finding themselves down 17-0, having to crawl back, botched the game-winning field goal, potential game-winning field goal, and ended up sending it to overtime where they were lucky enough to survive. USC has not looked like a top 10 team. They have not looked like a top 4 team. The opportunities will be there going forward when they play Notre Dame in South Bend this upcoming weekend, when they ultimately play Washington and Oregon. Those opportunities will be there for USC to skyrocket back in these rankings. But right now, we have dropped them out of our top 10. We have them in at number 12. We still need a lot to be proven from USC, something they haven't proven all year long. They have not proven they can just go in and decimate an inferior opponent. It's a bit of a concern if you're USC. It's a bit of a concern heading in to South Bend. Watch out for the Trojans, guys. High expectations. They're not living up to them right now. They come down to number 12, dropping out of our top 10, giving a team like Oklahoma in there, getting a team like Alabama back in there. Again, opportunities will be there for USC, but right now, we're keeping them out of that top 10 spot and well out of that top 4 until they can prove they are worthy. Louisville's in at number 13. Give credit to the Cardinals, guys. We didn't even have them ranked last week. We said they're right on the outside looking. They were 26, right? The AP poll had them at 25. We hate the AP poll. We had them at 26. We were like, can they beat Notre Dame? Can they? And they did. And they didn't just beat Notre Dame. They beat them 33-20. They destroyed them. They torched Sam Hartman, forcing 5 turnovers on the quarterback that had not thrown an interception all year long. So Louisville, for us, going from 26 all the way to 13th. Some say that's too high. I say it's not. That was an impressive performance against a good Notre Dame team. They're 6-0. They're playing great football right now. Jeff Brohm's got this team firing on all cylinders. Watch out for the Cardinals. You're talking about ACC contenders. You're talking about Florida State. You're talking about North Carolina. You better start talking about Louisville. Behind them, Ole Miss, they do not move following their 27-20 win over a bad, bad, bad Arkansas team. So they don't really deserve to move up anything like that, but don't deserve to drop down either. Washington State dropping 3 spots after losing on the road to UCLA. The Cougars taking their first loss of the season to the Bruins, 25-17 at the Rose Bowl. Had an 88-yard pick 6 that benefited them right before halftime, but the offense really could never get going. We're held to under 300 yards of offense on the day. UCLA had nearly 500 yards of offense on the day. Cam Ward getting stuffed on 4th-and-1 late in that game at the UCLA 40-yard line, and the Bruins escaping with a massive victory to continue to muddy up the Pac-12 conference race as they are trying to get a team into the college football playoff. But as we know, they're just going to keep beating up on each other. Washington State losing to UCLA. Oregon or Washington will lose on Saturday. Those teams still have to play USC. They're just going to continue to beat each other up. Will we get a team from the Pac-12 into the college football playoff, or will they just eat each other? That is what remains to be seen, but it's not looking good. Washington State dropping 3 spots, though, doesn't deserve to drop too far in our rankings. Because of that, they drop. Oregon State drops 1 spot. Washington State still owning the head-to-head over the Beavers. We're going to honor that as of now. Washington State still above the Beavers, who did win at California 52-40. Duke up a spot just because of all the movement ahead of them. Didn't play this week. back at number 17, Notre Dame, down a handful of spots. We touched on that game with the Louisville win. The Fighting Irish now have two losses on the year, that blowout loss to Louisville, that heartbreaking last-second loss to Ohio State. Well, Notre Dame does not deserve to fall out of the top 25. To me, they don't deserve to fall out of the top 20. This is still a very good team. But Notre Dame was a team that we had in the top 10, and now they are barely in the top 20. They definitely dropped a lot, but can find themselves rising back up those rankings if they can beat USC on Saturday. Utah stays at number 19. They had a bye week. They stay there. LSU up three spots following their road victory at Missouri. It wasn't pretty. It was ugly. It was a horrible defensive performance from both teams. Yet LSU coming up with the biggest defensive play of the day, that pick six with under a minute left, sealed the 10-point victory over the Tigers of Columbia, winning 49-39. A road win over a ranked opponent in the SEC. I know it wasn't pretty. They still deserve to rise a handful of spots. They're in at number 20. Ahead of a team like UCLA, who's back in our rankings following their win over Washington State. We just talked about that. So credit to the Bruins. They're in at number 21. Tennessee staying at number 22, coming off their bye week. And then three newcomers in a row, Kansas, Wyoming, Tulane, all cracking our top 25 for the first time this year, except for Tulane. Of course, they were in there earlier. This is a very, very fun top 25, guys. Kansas we have in there following their big, dominant 29-point victory over UCF. They did that without Jalen Daniels. That's what's impressive to me. You're going to harp on the loss to Texas, who they didn't have Jalen Daniels for then. Then they come back at home against UCF, start off as a favorite. Then we're an underdog because UCF is supposed to have John Rhys Plumlee back. He battled injuries throughout the game as well. Kansas, even if UCF had had John Rhys Plumlee, was going to win that game in convincing fashion, and they did. 51-22. It was very, very impressive. Only loss for the Jayhawks this year is on the road to Texas. Yeah, they're a top 25 team. Get them in at number 23. Wyoming, same can be said for them. Laramie, one of the toughest places to play in the country, dare I say. They beat Texas Tech back in week one. They just beat number 24, Fresno State, 24-19. Took Texas into the fourth quarter a couple weeks ago. That's the only loss they have on the year. It's on the road at Texas. Wyoming's playing some phenomenal ball, guys. Typically a team that's known for their defense. The defense is strong, but the offense is finally there to complement it. So watch out for the Cowboys, guys. The Mountain West race getting really interesting. Boise State is still an elite contender. Air Force, a very elite contender. Fresno State certainly is. Wyoming certainly is. This is going to be a fun conference to watch as we progress throughout the season. It could be the conference that produces the Group of Five champion that goes to a New Year's Six bowl game. But Tulane would love to have something to say about that as well. They're the reigning Group of Five champion that went to a New Year's Six bowl. They rejoin our top 25. Had a bye week this week. They were right on the outside of our top 25 looking in. They benefit from all the teams that lost ahead of them. Again, five teams in our top 25 losing and dropping out completely. Miami, Kentucky, Missouri, Kansas State, Fresno State, all dropping out of our top 25, opening the door for these three new teams to join, especially a team like Tulane that's still battling for that New Year's Six bowl spot. Though a huge game coming up this week against Memphis. So there you have it, guys. Our GE top 25 heading in to week 7 of the college football season, one that's going to be absolutely massive. We've got some huge games on deck, the biggest ones. Oregon, Washington, Notre Dame, USC, going to be phenomenal. We're going to have analysis on those games coming to you here in the next couple days right here on the channel. But get ready. These rankings will change drastically next week, just like they will every single week up until Selection Sunday. But this is what college football is all about. It's about change. It's about upsets. It's about chaos. And you know we're an advocate for chaos. And we know the season and the fun really is just beginning. So guys, as always, thank you so much for watching us here at the Gridiron Expert on YouTube. Make sure to continue to like, comment, subscribe, share our videos, and of course, check out everything down in the description below, including those expert picks over on our website, thegridironexpert.com. One of the best spread picks in the entire country, guys. We're on a 36-15 run over the last 5 weeks, hitting over 61% of our bets, over 75% in our best bet section. So if you want guaranteed winnings and big-time winnings, this is the place for you. Go sign up for those today. And once again, guys, as always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time right here on the Gridiron Expert. Yeah.